Hey church, we have begun a new series on the doctrine of the church. We're talking all about what the church is, and more specifically, or perhaps most specifically, who are the leaders that the church has to elect to run the organization of the church, lead the ministries of the church, what does the scripture say about who they are and how we select them. So as part of this series, we're trying to equip you as the body to be able to make decisions, read your Bible well, and help us to lead the church in a biblical direction. So I want to just give you some books that you might be able to go get, and at the end I'll even have a book giveaway that you can come and let us know that you want one, and we can get you a copy here from the church. So just a few giveaways or a few options. So the first couple books are, these are short books about different aspects of church and church ministry. So this comes from the Nine Marks Ministry. Nine Marks is an organization that specializes in all things church. They talk about pastors and elders and deacons and preaching and teaching and discipleship. They have these little books that are all probably around 100 pages, maybe 150 pages each, but they're small books, so they're easy to read, quick chapters, and they cover all the different areas of church that you might want to learn more about. So I have just a couple here with me, one on elders, which is a really good handy addition to use to study who are the church elders and what are they, what are they supposed to do. I have one on church membership, which is a great one to help you understand the ins and outs of why churches have membership. There's also several books that cover other aspects of ministry like preaching, teaching, discipling, missions, evangelism, and deacons. So you can go to ninemarks.org and you can just search through all of their available resources and articles, and then you can shop there. But all of these are also available on Amazon. I think they're around 10 bucks each, and they also have Kindle version if you like to read the Kindle version. So I would recommend getting these little short, easy to read copies of these different doctrinal books on the distinctives of the church. If you're looking for a book that includes more of a broad selection of topics and kind of covers them all in one shot, one of my favorite books about church and church ministry that I've read, and clearly I have really read it several times, and it's a great resource, is the book called Nine Marks of a Healthy Church. It's written by Mark Dever. You can get he's got a ton of free videos on YouTube and through the ninemarks.org website. Tons and tons of great biblical, very scripture-saturated information, and he walks through and explains in brief but concise and helpful detail what exactly the church is supposed to do. And Nine Marks of a Healthy Church is one of the best and easiest books to read that covers a whole range of topics within the church. So I highly recommend Nine Marks of a Healthy Church. It's a fantastic resource for you to study more about these topics. And lastly, I have one that I have, and we actually have 15 copies of this book to give away. I have them here in my office. So if you want to get a copy of this book, you can let us know. Just email us at info@cvgrable.org and just say, I want to get a copy of Rediscover Church. Now this book, which was written by Colin Hansen and Jonathan Lehman, and Jonathan Lehman is also associated with Nine Marks Ministry. Colin Hansen is associated with the Gospel Coalition. They came together and wrote this book specifically in the aftermath of the COVID-19 pandemic. So we all know that during COVID, many churches shut down, some began to really struggle, and others even had to deal with the questions of, should we gather as a church in the first place? What's the point? Or does it even make a difference? And so seeking to provide insight and wisdom and biblical clarity on, should we gather? What's the church supposed to do? These two gentlemen wrote this book, Rediscover Church. It's another relatively short and easy read. It's less than 150 pages. It's very at an easy reading level. If you're not well studied in things of doctrine of the church, that won't matter for this book. It's easy to read and easy to understand. But it's also a great resource to help you dive deeper into knowing, what is the church supposed to do? Who's the church supposed to lead? And how are we supposed to do this thing together as God's people? So I have 15 copies of this book. It'll be first come, first serve. 15 people who want it, we'll give it away. And I hope that it helps you to dive deeper into the things that we're talking about throughout this series. In the upcoming videos, we're going to look specifically at a few different things. And I just want to give you a heads up on where we're going. So we really want to dive deep into the leaders of the church. That's really what this series is supposed to be getting us to. We want to know who are the elders and who are the deacons. Now, if you've been around Crossview for a while, you know that we have a plurality of elders, a group of men who have been selected and appointed and voted on to serve in that capacity as leaders of our church. But you also might know that we do not currently have anyone filling in the role or the office of deacon. So we have a plan to address that shortcoming here at Crossview Church, but we want to make sure that you're well prepared to help us make those decisions, those important doctrinal decisions, so that we can pursue being a biblical church doing what Scripture says. So we're going to talk about elders, we're going to talk about deacons, we're going to talk about the difference between the two, and specifically we're going to go into 2 Timothy chapter 3, and we're just going to walk verse by verse through the qualifications of those two different offices and what kinds of things those people are supposed to represent and how they're supposed to behave and how we can go about picking them out to be the leaders of the church. So I encourage you to continue watching through these videos, get a hold of some of these resources, check out some of the free YouTube materials that we send out, and be reading deeply along with us so that together as a church, we can be making good biblical decisions and leading ourselves forward into the future.